I am here with New Day Georgia. Sometimes we call ourselves Georgia Together, but what we are Georgia Democrats, and that's all of us. And we are here for, of course, Hillary Clinton, and also Jim Barksdale, Sanford Bishop, for Bishop Hardman, for Donna Tompkins. We are here for everybody. All of us will depend on each other's coattails to make sure that we all go into office and make Georgia blue again. Let's not forget that this is exactly why we're here, for the next 43 days. Not 41, we're not taking off now, any Sundays. We are here every single day until 9 p.m., and we want to be here. And so when you come by, you know that we're going to be here. We are going to be fundraising every day. We're going to be canvassing every day, just walking from door to door. Over the weekend, we hit just under 600 homes. And people want to hear about Hillary Clinton. They want to hear about Donna Tompkins. They already know about and they know that we're in his corner. And when it comes to Bishop Hardman, the same thing. Everyone says, like, oh gosh, we have to do the box again. It's a pain, but we are here to do it. So the voters are so important. And we forget sometimes. People call them votes, but they are people who vote. When you go out there and ask them, they overwhelmingly say, we want to be Democratic. We are Democratic. We've been Democratic. Give us the chance to do what we do best and vote. So every single day, we have the Barksdale people here who have been just fantastic and rejuvenating, and we need that. We need everyone here. Also, I'm going to do a very big pitch for volunteering as well. Georgia Together, which is all of us, I'm going to be passing these around. And we are canvassing, we are going door to door every single day. We are phone making every single day. I would like everyone to get one of these and take a look at it and see if you can give us a shift. Because come November 9th, you don't want to ask yourself, gosh, can I have given another 2 hour shift? You don't want to ask yourself that. You want to do it right now. You want to do it right now. Every single day is the day to elect Hillary Clinton, to elect Bishop Hardman, to elect Sheriff, I keep calling you Sheriff, Sheriff Thomas, to re-elect Congressman Bishop, and of course to defeat Johnny Isaacson and put Senator, Mr. Barksdale in as Senator.
There we go.
It is so important that we support our hill. I'm just going to go, I love everyone, but you know, my hill, I mean, this is our time. And what Hillary is going to do for us is make sure, she's going to drive the ship, and we're going to be on the ship with her, but we have work to do. We have 43 days of foolishness, and then it's going to be over. And we have to have someone in there that is ready to go right away, to take what President Obama so generously gave us. When he came in, it was a really tough time, We are better now. We are better together. We are stronger together. So we know what we have to do. Thank you all for coming out and enduring this debate. You know, I know my hill's going to do well, and we know our hill's going to do well. I don't know what the pundits are going to say, but this is the woman who's we're all pitched to her, and we're all going to do this together. I hope to see each and every one of you in here a lot. We have the comfy couch back there. There is no excuse for you not to just think that this is your second home. It's already my first home. So come on down and grab one of these. We're going to have Charisse, who is our field organizer, and she will be distributing some of these volunteerships. We have Nick, who is our fellow, who will be doing the same. We are here, and we want you to be here with us from now on and take this journey with us, take this ride with us, and let's go. Let's go. Thank you, Patricia. I'm sure you're all inspired and not. Just look at yourself.
Before you end the program, there's two things we can talk about.
Okay, on this right here. See that big TV back there? We're wrapping that TV. Y'all could be giving away the night of the election. And the tickets are $5 each, or what's the option?
$5 for $20.
$5 for $20. Okay. So who do we see to get the tickets? change for you if you need it.
I know you all are ready to watch the debate, but there are two things I want to call to your attention. The first day for Sunday voting is October the
23rd.
And I stress that because it's very important that we have people. It's very important that we have people going to the poll on that Sunday. We fought very hard to have Sunday voting, and the participation hasn't been what we anticipated. So what we're doing is we're challenging congregations to leave their church, get on the church bus, take their people to the poll, and vote. And we say from pew to poll. And we'd like to see Mr. Washington here is our voter registration mobilization coordinator. So if you would go back, talk to your minister, your pastor, your bishop, your leader, whatever, and ask if your church could participate in a pew to the poll, and then contact Mr. James Washington here. And we're saying that we're gonna open up that Sunday and maybe serve Kool-Aid and other things. You just come by with a ticket that says I voted, and we pass it around here. We can start counting votes ahead of time. Now, you've heard about the top of the ballot, you've heard about the middle of the ballot, but there are gonna be five amendments that I wanna call your attention to. In particular, amendment number one, it sounds like pie in the sky. And that's the school opportunities. And some of you went to a forum tonight. We have literature over here for you. And I want to say, once you read it, just vote no for Amendment 1 and Amendment 3. Together, that makes 13. Try to remember. Vote no. We have a box of literature. We want you to take it home, educate your friends. Because if you read it, it sounds so positive, it sounds like something we want to do. But what it does is give control of the schools over to the governor, to someone he appoints as a superintendent, and then that just takes away local responsibility, takes away a lot of parental involvement, parental say-so. Just vote no. Take some of it, if you're not familiar with the issue, we have some flyers over there. We'll be doing more forums on it. There was one earlier today. And the amendment number 3, I'm not an attorney, but it speaks about the ethical issues of who we can get to run for judge. And what has happened, some of the judges that the governor appointed have been removed from office because of ethical issues. And what he's trying to do is to find another way that he can put them back on the bench. And so we're saying, vote no for Amendment 1 and Amendment 3. Tell the people, once they've made the commitment to vote, take the time and vote all the way down the ballot. We had some local candidates who ran for office when Barack Obama ran. And Obama carried Georgia, carried Columbus, those same candidates. On Democratic candidates on the ballot, lost because some people went in and voted for Obama and thought they were finished and walked out and left the local candidates hanging. Vote that complete ballot, vote up and down it. Vote no for Amendment 1 and 3. And I think that's, we talked about the raffle, that's a great television. So please come up and buy some raffle tickets. And thank y'all very much. And we're here, we're working, and we want to elect good Democrats. Thank you.
Yes.
All right, I think a couple of
they don't mind. Where are you, candidates? You don't mind answering questions. I mean, we didn't put you up here and let them throw them at you, so you have an opportunity.
Tell us what you need. Tell us what you need, what you want from us, what we haven't done, what you wish we do. This is family.
All right.
Well, what I mean is,
because one of the things that I think might be a problem is everyone feels that I've already won because of the primary. And so what we need to do is make sure we get everybody back to the polls and tell them to check the box. Because if not, some of the people that I've talked to think, well, she's already won. Why do we need to do it again? So that's what I mean. It's just making sure everybody knows.
All right, you won't
come. Mike Garner. Yeah, I try not to speak about polls. Because I get, that means I'm advertising them. So.
Okay, as for me, I would love to have some volunteers. I'm making phone calls. I have lists of voters, and I'm trying to remind them that early voting starts October 17th, election day is November 8th, and as I'm calling them, of course, I'm asking them to consider me to be their sheriff, and so if anyone would like to volunteer to make some of those phone calls for me, that would be great. We're trying to get that done before early voting starts, so please see me, and I've got, you know, a volunteer coordinator, but he's not here at the moment. So you can see me personally, and I will, he's coming. Okay. Yeah, I'm sure he's at the other event right now. So that's what I need. And also, if you just really want to walk with me, I'd love to have you walk with me one morning. We go every Saturday for sure, and then usually every week as well.
Okay, I was just informed Ms. Pam Brown is here. She's right in. Would you like to come up and say something?
I am one of them for the office of sheriff. I ran in 2012 as a Democrat, because I am a true Democrat. I will be running write-in since I was not qualified to run as a Democrat. And so I will be on the ballot. I ask that you consider me the chair and just go down and click the write-in box for our sheriff, type in my name, and get him. Thank you. Okay, you got a few minutes to just mingle and have a little fun. So the refreshments are over here, and the literature is, this is on the corner of the table. The literature is over here for you to get. In fact, any literature that you want is over there. Thank you.